Hi there and welcome back, friends of a thoughtful gaming experience. This is your host, Emmanuel Ken. And we're going to proceed our Torment Tides of Numenera Let's Play and Explore. Last time we helped Finzin and we made some discoveries around here with a strange moving triangles that are intelligent and all of that stuff. And this time I thought we are going to go into this area and look what that's about, right? We haven't seen these people yet, and just let's talk to them. Maybe they can help us. Or we can help them. Jernorg. This old man's skin is covered in makeup painstakingly drawn to resemble dark stone. His eyes widen briefly as he notices you, and his face and neck hardens into an actual obsidian for a moment, and he smiles and nods at you, his features mobile once more. Welcome, welcome, he says. Sorry about the stone, polymorphic flesh modification, you see. I didn't see you walk up, and I assumed you were going to cut my throat and take my chirurgical parlor for yourself. Hey, the days, yeah. Why would you think such a thing? I do good business here, the old man shrugs. If I were a younger man looking to make a name for myself in this city, I'd kill me too. My chirurgical parlor is a marvel of the prior world, you see. Just pick an item or a service, pay my outrageous fees, and after only a short to long period of fairly safe but indescribable agony, you walk away with some horrible Numenera bits whirring away inside you. He pokes a few buttons on a device strapped to his wrist and lights twinkle across its length. A dark, glassy lens focuses on you. Well, interested? First, I can't help noticing that you're a very honest man. Well spotted, he says, nodding. Clear streaks of quartz run up his prominent cheekbones, revealing the muscle beneath. It's a side effect of my modifications. Couldn't lie to you if you begged me to. He shrugs. Honestly, honesty is actually usually a hindrance to businessmen, but people seem to like it. Scan thoughts. It's a blessing, in my opinion. How did you come to own this parlor? Well, it was originally a partnership, he says. My colleagues and I unearthed one of the antennas you see here and spent the next 2 years digging it out and getting the whole mess working. He sighs. Of course, we had to test the drones before we tried them on anyone else. Customers getting skinned alive on opening day is bad for business. Turns out that was a wise move. Gorna chose an intelligent modification and the drones cut off his head to work on it more directly. Maya picked strength and the drones sliced off his arms. They did default to severe in those days. Smiles fondly. Anyway, six partners later, I was the sole proprietor. I worked out the kinks, and here we are, with no fatalities in, he thinks, months. No fatalities in months. Scan thoughts. The strongest survived. Of course, it might not have been me, but, well, it was. Show me your list of items and services. Of course, he says, tapping a few buttons on the broad device encircling his wrist. The lens beams a cone of light directly onto your eye, which immediately begins watering. Blinking, you see a menu of items seemingly hanging in the air. The clawed gauntlets, the jagged memory, the encroaching darkness, what are blood nanites? Alright, an artificial eyeball. Just how painful are these procedures? That is a popular question, he says, and it does vary from procedure to procedure, but if you're seeking a general area, he taps his chin thoughtfully. My customers usually range between shrieking for a merciful death and groaning while soiling themselves, if that helps, but they almost always seem happy with the results when they survive. He smiles. Now, are you ready to buy something? Not really. Can I ask you questions about something else? There's nothing new. All right. But I won't miss you, but I'll miss your money. Interesting. Let's look at these things. The books jamming the shelves of this desk are divided equally between obscure medical texts and mechanical how-to manuals. And this? These shelves abound with beakers, flasks, and other myriad containers. That a lack of labels on any of them is somewhat worrying. The shape of this operating table provides little information regarding the physiology of the beings it was originally designed to treat. Alright, so you could get upgrades here, it seems. But we're not going to do this yet. Just at the start. Don't even mean know what these upgrades will bring us. Don't even know what we want, really. And we'll just speak with this guy here, Pico. Hello, Pico. The mutant boy gazes at the entrance to the chirurgical parlor, flinching at each scratch of razor metal on metal from within. By your estimation, he is in his late teens, but is the size of a young, malnourished child. His arms are little more than bone wrapped in red speckled skin, and a raw line zigzags down between his mismatched eyes and over his blade of a nose, as if pointing directly at his thin lips. He sees you looking, and bird-like muscles flex in his frail jaw. Get a good look, he says, lifting his chin. Or maybe you want to call me some names. I hear eggshell and not a lot, or maybe lightning bolt. I get that one from time to time. He crosses his bony arms and glares at you. Don't let me stop you. Call me some names. Laugh, do it now, because in another few minutes I'll be the one laughing. Calm down, Earthquake. Are you threatening me? What? Pico says, gaping. Then he waves his twig-like arms like he's trying to take flight. Look at me, I'd have to be an idiot to threaten you. That's not what I meant. I'm not going to be the butt of everyone's jokes anymore, he says. Electricity sizzles briefly within the nearby parlor. This time he does not flinch away. Lightning flickers, trapped in his determined eyes. I have some money, all right. I'm going to use it to change myself. Change everything I can. What sort of changes are you considering? Right, he says with a bitter laugh, like I'm going to take advice from a girl. You don't like women? What? No, I like women, and they like laughing at me. We get along just fine. I'm not laughing at you, Pico. Aha, you're talking to me out of charity or pity. I don't want either. I'm not laughing at you, man. Alright, can everyone buy improvements from the parlor? Yes, he says. You pay the keeper and the drones remake your body the way you want. What happens in the parlor again? Oh no, let's try this again. What happens in the parlor again? The drones remake people and it costs an ocean's worth of shins. Well, goodbye. Oh, he's just telling us about this parlor. Interesting. And what's in here? Salty air only partially mutes the cloud of putrid sweetness clinging to this jumble of fallen wood, stone, and iron. Don't have any might anymore, so search it for valuables. Shift aside broken pieces of furniture and small pieces of rubble, but you find nothing of value. After a short while, you realize what has happened. Someone has already picked through these ruins and taken the more accessible valuables. You stand back, concentrating. Nothing about the pile of stone is familiar, but the view from where the door once stood. A boundless horizon falling into the sea is... Study the horizon. Let's take this easy thing. Fingers of wind rake at your face. You squint into the sunlight, trying to remember. You've stood here before, you know you have, letting your thoughts untangle. The skyline tilts and you stagger as the magmary engulfs you. You grip the edge of the crude banister, grimacing the sea. The calm of the sea no longer touches you as it once did. Nor, you realize, does this body. You smile at your own impatience. Your restlessness must rival the ocean itself. A gust of salty air bears the memory away in ribbons, leaving your mind aching and dry atop the ruins of the house. Don't have any might anymore, so we can't do anything here. the changing god cultists here can try to talk to them. They don't have anything to say. Oh. Surprise briefly registers on the cultist's face when she sees your tattoo. Then she inclines her head respectfully. Beloved vessel, I don't believe we've met before. Do Kazmin and Mimion know you're visiting us? I think someone may have looted that ruined house against the cliff. Did you see who it was? Yes, the cultist says. A mischievous expression crosses her face. But I wonder if I can convince you to share something with us in exchange. She ignores the startled looks from her fellow cultists. Will you tell us about your birth? We'll tell the truth here. Very well, I awoke miles above the world, falling to my death. You can't be serious, she says, blanching. It's true. Without getting into the particulars, I survived the fall and came to understand myself. Amazing, she says, shaking her head. None of you were lucky enough to wake up in bed, were you? She clears her throat. Well, a deal's a deal. We did see someone looking around the rubble before you arrived, she says, glancing toward the pile of rubble. Dirty children, orphans perhaps, were digging through the rocks. I believe they took some food and valuables, but we were trying not to stare. Thank you and goodbye. There is one of the Dendra or her. Let's talk to them. Let's talk to him. Is that possible? The flesh creeps if you let it. If you let it! Oh yeah, alright, Mr. Cannibal. We'll go elsewhere to talk. What more is it we can find here? Facade is all that remains of a house. Tragic reminder of the impermanence of existence. What's this? A months-old layer of dust cakes this sign. Treats Skorar the Wise, Scholar of the Iron Wind. And she's fallen down, it seems. Maybe these children here? What's this? Continual rise and fall of the pistons on this device suggests a massive mechanical effort. Structural similarities with the pipes in the area hint at them being part of the same machine. Alright, before we speak to these orphans, we'll just call this a day because I'm out of time. So thank you for watching. If you liked this episode, please come again and watch. There'll be more, and especially from the first playthrough, I know that in this area there's some action, some interesting stuff as well. So stay tuned, please come again and watch. This is Immanuel Kern wishing you happy gaming and signing out.